This conference will now be recorded.
Okay. What is a collection? Collection is a group of objects or a collection of objects where we will apply operations like searching, sorting, deleting, traversing, right? When you want to do such kind of operations on it, we need some holder who can hold this collection of our group of objects. That holder, the different holders are there. Okay, let me give an example. Okay, let's take an employee table. Okay, let's take an employee table. Not only employee, you take any table, employee table. You have a records like this. Okay. When you have an employee table, this employee table, you want to read from the database. You want to read from the database and this.
You want to read from the database.
You want to read from the database and display in the console. Display in the console or display in the web application, any of the web page. So for that, what we will do, we will create one POJO class as we discussed in the last Friday, right? So the POJO class will be class employee. You will declare all the things: ID, name, salary, department, date of birth, date of join. Okay, these are all private members. And you will write some setters or getters. Okay, I'm just trying to say setters and getters. Okay, now with the help of the JDBC, you connect it to the employee table, database. From the Java application, you connect it to the, with the help of the JDBC. With the help of the JDBC, you connect it to the RDBMS system, and you started reading the table, employee table. Now, while you are reading the employee table, every record, let me make it to this one, different records, 2, 3, 4, 5. Every record you read, you need to consider one object. Every record will be one object. Try to remember this, guys. So here, employee object, whatever the employee object you create, let's say the first record is belong to Ravi. Like this you have. Okay, when you start read the first record will be created an employee object. First record will be created employee object. It means when you read the table, whatever the result you get, that result will be collection of employee objects. Collection of employee objects. Okay. Whatever you create, result that is nothing but one second. Amo. Collection of employee objects. That collection of employee objects are nothing but one record. First record you read, right? That is Ravi record. Second record, Ravi object, Veera object, Kumar object. Like that, you'll get a group of objects. You'll get. So when you get this group of objects, you need to put into some holder, right? Someone should hold it. No, someone should hold it. Like the someone is. Some type should be hold it. It is list, either a set. Someone should hold, no? Either you should have either a bag, other you should have some kind of the holder who can hold it, right? That collection of objects holding we will call what I can say, like collection of objects. You guys got what is a collection of objects? Is this clear? Yes, no?
Yes, sir.
Now there are different type of group of objects we can hold. List type, set type, map type, like that. We have a different type of objects we can hold. Okay. These different type. One second, I don't think. I think I should have. I have somewhere it is. I have drawn some diagram. I'm just looking for the diagram. I don't know why it is not showing here, but I'll find and show that diagram. Okay, there is a different kind of flow chart. I mean, class hierarchy is there. Okay, I'll explain that hierarchy later. First, let's see the list and set type. Okay, these are two categories, guys. These are two categories of holders, or I can say data structures. These are two type of list and set are two different type of data structures. List is one type of data structure. Set is another type of data structure. List, the way it hold is different. Set, the way to hold the holding the objects is different. Okay, let's try to understand the list. The most important in interview, people will ask, what is the difference between the list and set? What is the difference between the list and set? Okay. List is backed by the back end. The list back end is array. The list back end is array. It means when you keep on putting the objects into the list, it is backed by array. It means the backend data structure of list is array. Okay, so it means when you're putting the data into the list, it will have index. It will maintain index. So you guys remember, right? Array. If you're writing the elements into the array, the background, it has index. First, zeroth index, first index, second index, third index, and so on. It has an index. Yes or no? Array has index or not? Does array has an index or not? Am I audible?
Yeah, the array has index.
Similarly, your list also has index. So what is the advantage if you have index? The advantage of it is you can
traverse randomly through data.
Pick. Yes, you can traverse through, you can randomly pick the data. So, and second feature of the list is, since it has an index, insertion order maintain. It maintains insertion order. Insertion order. Not the sorting order or something. Insertion order. It has an insertion order. So insertion order means there is a object called Ravi object. It came first place. So zeroth position it will go. So Veera object, it will go to first position. Kumar object, it will go to second position. Scala object, it will go to third position, like that. So the order will be there. When you're traversing through or when you're picking, the order will be there. That's called insertion order. Insertion order. And third feature of this list is it can allow the duplicates. It can allow the duplicates. So there is no worry about it. Suppose you want to hold the duplicate objects. We can use a list. It allows the duplicates. The most important features, try to remember. The list allows the duplicate. Obviously, your array allows the duplicates, right? How many times we didn't enter? 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like that. In the array, you can have a duplicates. No one will stop, no. Array can have a duplicates. So your list allows the duplicates. Not only allowing the duplicates, it allows nulls also. There is a possibility the null objects also you can keep. Are you getting my point, guys? These are the features of list. And the size is not fixed. While you are discussing about arrays, if you guys remember, the size is fixed. Yes or no? While we're discussing about arrays, once you declare the size is fixed. Here the size is not fixed. The size will automatically grow. Suppose my size is 5, I declared. When I insert the 6th element, it will grow. The size will be double. So 5 I declare, it will become 10. So auto grows. Size will grow automatically. The next immediate you can ask, sir, when I have a list, no, when I have array, then why did the use of the list, sir? Then immediate next question is, all these features are there in the array, then why should I go with the list? So in the array, you don't have the dynamically growing size. dynamically growing size is not there, and array always holds same type of objects. Yes or no? Array is a linear list of elements. Linear list of elements with the same data type. Yes, homogeneous. So homogeneous, but list heterogeneous. You can have any type of elements in it. You can have any type of elements in it. Try to remember these features, guys. The most important features in interview, people ask. You have to tell. So list maintain index, list will have insertion order. List allows the duplicates. It allows, it can hold the null values. Okay, when it comes to the set is different. When it comes to the set, set is different. Okay, let's see the first list, how the list works. Then we will see in detail about the others. Okay, let me close all of these applications. First, see the list demo. Simple list, okay. Simple list. Okay, and one more thing I want to tell you, the different ways we can create a list. Okay, different ways we can create a list. So one of the ways, you look at here, this is one of the way. Element colon colon, element colon colon, element colon colon, and last you should have the nil. At last you should have the, it should end with the nil. If it is not end with the nil, it will not create a list, it will give error. This is one way of doing it. Lists are immutable. You need to understand one thing. There are mutable lists, immutable lists. Two type of lists are there. Mutable means you can modify. Once you create, you can add elements, you can modify elements. Same object will get modified. That's a mutable. Another type is immutable. Another type is immutable. I'll show you the both of them. I'll give the I can say examples for the both of them. Okay, since it is an introduction class, so try to keep understand the basic things. The going forward we'll see in the advanced things. Okay, another way of declaring it, this is another way of doing it. This is another way of doing it. Okay, let me run these two. Okay, both will be created as a list. There won't be any issues with them. Whatever the way you create, no issue. Let's look at here. Look at here. Try to understand one by one. Line number 6. I already shown, right? That's the one way of, that's the one way of creating a list. That's one way of creating the list. Keep the init one late. I'll explain this later. For now, it's just to keep it aside. Line number 8, another way of creating it. Line number 9, range, using range. That's one way of creating it. Line number 10. That's also another way of creating it. Okay. Let me execute a line by line. Let me execute a line by line. Okay, list created. No issues. List created, no issues. This is also list created. Look at the differences. All are integer type only. No issues, no differences. List created. But this one prints differently. This one prints differently. Look at here, guys. 1111. Because you have given the same element. Yes, you have given the same element. The first two elements represent how many times it has to print. Second argument represent that what has to print. Okay. Next. Let me show you this one also. Can anyone guess what happens with the line number, with the last statement which I'm printing?
Step two, to print only even numbers.
Alternate, yes, alternate elements. 1, 3, not even numbers. So it started with one, because it's odd numbers. 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 14, 17, 19. Because started with one, right? If it start with a zero, yes. It's even numbers. Okay. Similarly, this one also similar kind of one. Don't worry about these methods. I'll explain everything in detail. Okay. So actually it is total 5 elements, and every element it is multiplied. First it printed 0, well and good. 0 into 0, it's a function, guys. Okay, it's a lambda function, right? First I want the first 5 elements. 5 means I want the first 5 elements. Okay, I want the first 5 elements. So it takes the first element 0. First, ELE get the 0. 0 into 0, 0. Next, 1. 1 into 1, 1. Next, 2. 2 will come here. 2 into 2, 4. Next, 3. Sequence, no. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So, 5 means 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes or no, guys? 5 position, 5 elements or 5 position means, if it start with 0, 4 only will get, no. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 0, the function is applied. 0 into 0, 0. For element 1, which is number 1. Number 1, 1 into 1 is 1. Number 2, 2 into 2, 4. Number 3, 3 into 3, 9. Number 4. 4 into 4, 16. You got it, guys? Tablet, what it is doing? Whatever the function you are passing, with respect to that function, it is creating a list on a sequence of numbers and based on the numbers. Is this clear to everyone? Please make a note of all these different ways of creating a list. Please make a note of this. Once you make a note, please let me know. Is everyone make very note of them? Next. There are different methods available in the list, guys. There are different methods available in the list. As you already know, as I said, like it is backed by array. It is backed by array. So if it is array, we can bring that element by element. Yes or no? By passing the position, we can get the elements. By passing the elements, position, we can get the element. Look at here. By passing the position, we can retrieve them. List of 0, position 1. So list 1, 0 position, the value is 1. List 2, 15th position, value is 16. You can see that this is the list 2. You can see list 2. 1, 2, 3, and so on. We got it. 0, list 4. This is the list 4, range. So we took the alternate elements. So position 5, what is there? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It will print 11. Print 11. Okay. So if you want to pass a position, get the element, you can do that. If you want to pass the position and get the element, you can do that. Okay. Next, if you want to concatenate, if you want to concatenate two lists, if you want to concatenate two lists, look at there, different ways of doing it. If you want to concatenate, when you concatenate there, don't think that it is getting modified. No, it is not getting modified. It is creating a new. It is not getting modified. It is creating new. Okay, so if you are modifying an existing object, or if you are modifying an existing object, if it get modified instead of creating new one, that's a mutable. But these lists are immutable. These lists are immutable. They will create a new one instead of modifying an existing one. There is a separate mutable lists. We'll talk about them later. There are mutable lists. We'll talk about them later. If you want to concatenate, use triple colon or plus plus, or use the list, this method. Let's execute one by one. Guys, first we saw the declaration. Second, we saw the retrieving the positions. Third, we are seeing concatenating. So make one when operation we are trying. And also, as per our definition, list is indexed elements. Yes or no? Is it proven or not? So we are passing index and we are getting the element. We are passing the things and we are, and third one, what I have told you, list, we can allow the nulls and duplicates, correct? List can allow the duplicate order. Also, you can see whatever the order you are putting. Let me do here one example. Var or the order equal to list. I'm putting the order, insertion order. I told insertion order, not the sorting order. 1, 5, 2, 10, 8, 6, or 5. 6. Null. Okay. Present. You got the order or not? Same order. Whatever the order you inserted, the same order. It is allowed a null. It allowed duplicate. 5-2 times came. And also different data types. Let me explain your different data types. Null 10.0d. Vera. f. F means fold, float. D means double. I have given the string also. I have given the character also. I will give boolean also. Look at there. It allows any time. Sir, how it takes the data type, sir? How it considers the data type? One example, let me show you. Let me remove this stuff. I'll take only number type stuff because we have two different types. Any reference, any value. Let me take all or any value type. These are all any value type, not the reference. There is no reference at all here. Reference types means objects. You guys remember data types, reference types, value types. So I've taken all the value types. These are all value. These are not references. These are values. So I'm pressing enter. You see the data type, what it comes. It comes double. It taken the double. Why it took the double? Why not integer? Any guesses? Why it took the double? Why not integer? Let me show you. I have already. This one is there. No. We have a diagram, no? Somewhere we have.
It will be the preference of data types nearest to parent and the highest preference.
Yeah,
double takes the priority.
No, double is the biggest. One second. I don't know where I kept my mouse. I got it. Let me reduce the size fonts. Okay, now look at byte, sort, int, long, float, double. So double is the biggest vessel. So in this array list, in this array, you have a double. That's the reason it took the double. Suppose in this array, I don't have a double. Now, what will be the biggest element? Float. As per the diagram, what is the next biggest? Float. Yes or no, guys? So, in that list, whichever is the biggest data type with respect to the memory allocation, so that will take. Clear, guys? Are you guys getting my point, what I'm trying to show? Are you guys following me? This is important. You guys need to understand which data type will take while you're declaring. If it is a mix of reference and value, this is a value type. Okay, this is a value type which I'm talking about. This is value type because all the values will be here. These are all values. These are all references. Java objects, Scala objects, string, any other things are there, null. These are all, null is reference type. Null is reference type. null is reference type. Nothing is value type. Nothing and null both are same. The one data type is difference. Let me show you here. Now I'll declare here false. Boolean is a value type only, no? Boolean is a value type only. Boolean, unit, boolean, char, these are all value type only. Any value. Suppose if I declare nothing here. It should be Kaplan. I think so. Let's be on there. Is it in a single quote? Why nothing is not coming? I think it needs to be declared differently. Not sure, guys. I didn't use any term. I'll check and come back on this. Okay. Nothing means it's not, nothing is there. It is not something we declare. I'll confirm it once again. Suppose if I mix with the, this is any value. Okay, look at here, any value. But if I declare combination of, let's say now it's a string, okay. Combination of like this, it will take any. It'll take any. Why it took any? Because it has the combination of values and reference. Don't forget this hierarchy. Any value, any reference. This, when it's a combination of number and string, number and reference, then it will be considered as any. Any is the top. Any is the top. Top level object. In Scala. Is this clear to everyone? Are you guys following me? So whatever I have explained, the features of the list, it has index, it allows the duplicate, it maintains insertion order, it dynamically grows. I'll show that dynamically grows. It has a different data types of the same data. All are proven. Okay, next, concatenation I'll show. Concatenation I'll show. Okay, let's execute these things. Look at here, guys. After concatenating, the lists are grown. Okay, this is how you can do the concatenation. If you have any questions so far, please ask me. I'll try to answer. Then we will discuss. Other things. There are so many things, guys. This is the biggest file. There are so many things. Look at here. There are so many things we need to discuss. Okay. Deletion. Combination, different data types. List string. Okay. Adding element in the list. So there are a lot of things are there. Also, there is a few more here. This is how we'll add. Okay, different list buffer is a mutable one. Okay, we'll talk about these things. Any questions so far? Any questions? You can have a list of lists, array of arrays. How we'll have one array, it contains another arrays. Similarly, list, it contains a different list. So like this, this is a list. Inside the list one, list two, this is a list of lists. So we'll discuss these things also. Let me execute these things for you and just show all this. Explore, show the things. But anyway, we'll see tomorrow how to traverse through the list. I'll show you. First one is list of list. So this is a list. Inside you have one more list. List, outside list, inner list, inner list, inner list. The list of lists. This is list of lists. One list contains multiple lists. So when you do flatten, flatten is the another important method. We will discuss about them. Flatten, flattening, it will break all the lists, it will make it single list. Flattening, flatten means flattening. Distinct, it will give you only distinct elements. Distinct, it will give only distinct elements. We'll discuss that again tomorrow. Distinct, it will give the only distinct lists. After flattening, if you do the distinct, it will bring only the distinct elements. Okay. So any questions, guys? Any questions? Okay, so if no questions, we'll stop here. Tomorrow we'll continue with the lists only, because it's quite important. There are different lists also I want to show you. Sequence, list, in the inside that you have a different lists. We will discuss all of them in the next session. Any questions? Yeah. So if no questions, we can leave for the day. We'll connect in the morning.
Yeah, Ravi, can you please upload the video?
I will upload.
Yeah. Thank you.